Extra, extra, read all about it. Sunscreen has been in the news, but not all press is good press.
Spray-on sunscreens have gotten some bad PR recently. The Food and Drug Administration has warned of at least 5 incidents in which people wearing spray-on sunscreen near flame sources suffered burns.
And this has a major skin impact.
Sunscreens come in all types: sticks, roll-on solids, creams, powders, and spray form. But we recommend you stay away from the spray.
That's because the alcohol used in the spray-on sunscreen formulations can make them flammable, even if you spray it while standing away from a grill or a citronella candle.
What's more, spraying your dose of sunscreen rather than rubbing it on skin makes it harder to gauge whether you're applying evenly and thoroughly. An SPF 50 can act just like an SPF 3 if you only apply a thin layer. So even generous application is key to protecting skin.
For best results, opt for a more traditional delivery. We urge our patients to manually apply and layer their sunscreen 30 minutes before heading outdoors. Then reapply it when you arrive at your destination, and especially every 2 hours after that if you're swimming or sweating.
That way you'll have a fighting chance of achieving the full SPF rating and maximizing the potential UVA protection of your product.
As you protect your skin this fall and beyond, use sunscreen the right way without the spray. I'm Dr. Katie Rodan.
I'm Dr. Kathy Fields.
Skin, it's a beautiful thing.
Wear it well.
Skinpact, it's not about celebrities, it's about you.
And for advice on your journey to great skin, visit our blog at DermRF.com.